I'm going to show you two of the most common end stop sensors. This is one type, and here's another type. Now I'm going to review for you the pins that we talked about previously. Here are our end stop pins. This is X min. This is X max. This is Y min. This is Y max. This is Z min. And this is Z max. Now each one of these pins has a breakout of positive, negative, and signal. So I'll show you how to wire these two different sensors onto them. The first type is a package sensor. Let me weigh it down over here for you. Zoom out a little for you. Okay. And on here, we have the positive, the negative, and the signal. So to attach that to X-Min, it's going to be the very top pin. Now this one's wired a little different. You only have two wires. You don't use the center one. And we're only going to connect it to the negative pin and the signal pin. Okay. In a couple of seconds, I'll show you how we check the logic of them. Okay, connected to the computer. Okay, we have Chronoface open. Looks like the COM port is 3 and the speed is right there. Let's connect and see what happens. So it looks like it connected fine. Now with both end stops not actuated, we're going to type M119 to see what their status is. And it looks like they're all triggered. So now we're going to actuate both of them. So this is the X-Min that's actuated. And it says open. So it's the opposite of what we want. Now let's try the X-Max. And it says nothing. So we have to go into the Marlin firmware, make a change, and upload it so we can see the X max and flip the logic for the X min. So I'm going to go to Marlin and open up the solution file. And we're going to first disconnect our connection to Chronoface so that we can use Marlin. Now Marlin, we're going to go to configuration and do control F, and we're going to search on end stop. Search a second time, and it says end stop settings. So we're going to scroll down and see what we got here. So it looks like we can only use at the moment X-min, Y-min, and Z-min. So let's uncomment this so we can show you how it works. And down below, where it says inverting, we're going to invert the logic for X-Min to true. And for X-Max, we're going to do the same. Now we're going to save it. And we're going to compile and upload after we double check to see our port is specified, which it is. So we're compiling and uploading. Okay, now that the upload's complete,
I'm going to go back to Prana Phase, reconnect, and do our M119 without touching the sensors. Well, it says the X-Men now is open, so let's actuate it and try it again. Now it says triggered. Let's try the opposite with the other switch. So now it says YMAX is open. So the logic on the other switch is backwards. So easy way to correct it. Let's go back. Change the inverted logic back to false if you're using that type of sensor. And then recompile and upload. Don't forget to disconnect from Prana Phase while you're doing this. So we're going to reconnect with Prana Phase. Going to try M119 again. Now it says they're both open. Now we're going to hold down the switch on the X-Max and try it again. Now it says triggered. Now we'll try the X-Min. It says triggered. So if you like my video, please press the like button. I'll try and do a video every week, and thank you for your time.